Welcome to the Dow High versus Midland High Girls Swimming. Dow High is coached by Renee Allen and Carl Chili Smith, and Midland High is coached by Buffy Hall and Pat Welter. Dow High's captains are Elizabeth Maraskin, Kelly Ballard, and Hannah Jacobs. And Midland High's captains are Allie Kiekhafer, Kayla Patnode, and Catherine Vermeer. Tonight, Dow High is the host team, and they will be swimming in lanes 2, 4, and 6. Midland High will be swimming in lanes 1, 3, and 5. My name is Kurt Branstedt. I'm the father of sophomore Sarah Branstedt and senior Ben Branstedt, who both swim for the Dow High Chargers. I've been involved in and supported the sport of swimming as a swimmer, coach, fan, and parent over time. This will be an exciting night at the pool.
Yeah, and sitting with Kurt today, my name is Doug White. I'm also the father of freshman Katie White from the Dow High Charger swim team, and also my son, Kevin White, who swims for the boys as well. I've got a long background in swimming. I swam through high school and in the collegiate ranks, and have been involved with coaching very early in my career, and now I'm just a proud father and hoping to help out well tonight with Kurt this evening. One of the things I have to mention just before the meet starts tonight is that there was a great rendition of the Star Spangled Banner, Kurt, and that's the first time I've seen where both teams, Dow High and Midland High, came together for a great rendition, singing as a choral group, the Star Spangled Banner. So if it didn't get captured on the telecast tonight, it was really nice to see.
One unified voice, both teams singing together, almost 70 plus strong, freshman through senior.
And I think we're going to get started here pretty shortly, so why don't we set up the first events, and I'm sure we have a lot to talk about. One of the themes I think through tonight will be the long history of all the coaches and both teams involved and how they've crossed paths probably over their coaching careers, and some have been the coach of each other or coached together. So I think the one theme you'll see tonight is that both teams are large and they're both deep and they both have a lot of fun swimming, and the teams are very familiar with each other. For the first event tonight, as we set up, you'll notice that Midland High will be the visiting team and Dow High will be the home team, although both teams practice in this pool, so really there's no true home pool advantage here this evening. But Midland will be swimming predominantly in lanes 2, 4, and 6, and Dow High will be swimming in 1, 3, and 5. The first event that's going to be starting shortly is the 200 medley relay. And they'll be setting those up shortly. They're still getting, I think, the block set and the timers ready as the girls get ready to swim.
I'll give a shout out to the timing corps tonight who have been working seamlessly through the season to provide the timing for the coaches. As Doug mentioned, they're getting set to launch the meet, getting the boards out of the way so that we can have safe entry into the water. The timers are a composition of both adults and swimmers from the boys' team supporting the girls' team tonight. As Doug mentioned, not only do the two teams support each other on the girls' front, the boys do as well, and then vice versa, boys with the girls and girls with the boys. So it's nice to see. We've seen that throughout the season. I would say 60 to 70% of our timers are directly from the boys' team.
Yeah, and all these meets take a lot of volunteers, and don't they, Kurt? So even down to the announcer, and there's a lot of people that have come back from this meet. I know in the booth today, Patty Smith, who came back, who was actually a coach with some of these people 30 years ago, is helping out and just trying to take part again and revisit how the teams change and the girls change, obviously, over time.
As you can see on the television, the pool is really decorated festively for tonight's senior night. So you can see the green and gold balloons for Dow High, and going up right now are the blue intertwined with the gold so that we get the mixture. That represents the joint pool, the joint colors of the two teams participating tonight.
Yeah, I saw some blue and gold noisemakers going out through the crowd too. So believe me, I think both teams are well represented here in the crowd today. Like I said, as we get set up, the first event will be the 200-yard medley relay. I know that as they get the timer set up, you'll notice that in all the events, there will be multiple heats. And so, in general, scoring will be precluded to the second heat. That's kind of the finals heat. But because both teams are so large, there'll be multiple heats in many of the events. And expect to see some pretty good races tonight. I know both teams are large and And from some of the feedback we got from the coaches, the swimmers have been improving pretty dramatically throughout the year.
I'll comment that before the meet began, the pep band came in from Dow High and provided some music, which in the pool space was actually pretty engaging.
Yeah, pretty overwhelming. They definitely filled the building with some good music. So I think we're ready to go, if not a little hard of hearing.
Before the meet begins, typically the girls will actually gather and they'll cheer, and then the other team will cheer. Obviously, the teams are very respectful of one another. They take turns cheering different, very intricate cheers back and forth. But with the pep band present, they were, I think, pretty excited. So I think this first event, they're going to be pretty excited to go.
Yeah, I think so too. So just describing the first event, it will be the 200-yard medley relay. And this is a relay that mixes all four strokes in a relay fashion. So each swimmer will swim two lengths of the pool, and in this case the first swimmer will swim the backstroke, the second swimmer will then launch into the butterfly, the second swimmer will swim the breaststroke, the third swimmer will swim the butterfly, and then the anchor swimmer will swim the freestyle event. So in this event, I believe both teams are very strong. I know Dow High has actually already achieved the state cut, so some of their swimmers have already qualified for the state meet here, so they might be the early favorite in this. But I know at a recent MISCA meet, which was another cutoff meet, Midland also had a team involved too. So hopefully we'll see a lot of close races tonight, and but more importantly, a lot of best times for the individual swimmers as they go forward. This is really their last dual meet before the big Valley swim meet, which they'll be tapering for, and expect to, you know, to see, if not some qualifying times today, some close, with the expectation in 2 weeks to achieve their fastest times just before the state meet in order to try to qualify there.
As Doug mentioned, the 200 medley relay is an exciting relay from the stance that four individuals, one relay team, each representing one of the four strokes, working together to achieve these times, like a state qualifying time in the state of Michigan or a top time in the Saginaw Valley League, really takes all four swimmers representing that group to make their way through that eight-length period.
And while we have a little moment here, why don't we just go ahead and do a public announcement. Just a reminder, you're watching this Midland High versus Dow High swim meet on MPS-TV 190 on Charter, or Channel 99 on AT&T U-verse in Midland. This event will be shown at the following dates and times. The first broadcast will be Wednesday, October 21st at 12:45 p.m. The next one would be Thursday, October 22nd at 1:15 p.m. Then it'll be retelecast again Friday, October 23rd at 1:15 p.m. And then finally, on Saturday, October 24th at 1 p.m. We'll be announcing this several times throughout the meet. So you, if you're watching this live and want to re-watch any other portions of it, feel free to join us again. For the times and dates, they're also available, or just stream this program online at any time, check the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org. Well, I think they're about ready to start, Kurt. I think they're just getting some final things in check. A lot of the meet really requires on a pretty elaborate timing system. So back in the days, I know when I swam, we used to rely on hand timers and handwriting, but everything's automated now, and the times are projected immediately, and timers are basically just used as a backup. And you're our chief timer, so you can give some the relative importance of that activity.
Absolutely. In fact, as Doug mentioned, it does take quite a few volunteers to actually bring the timing to the meet to back up the swimmers as they complete their event. So we want to make every effort to provide a time to that swimmer. So first and foremost, we have the touch pad. It's actually in the water, and we'll start with the start of the race initiated by the official, and we'll land when the swimmer actually touches the pad and actually completes the race. If the touch pad fails to stop at that point in time, there's a backup plunger, which we have two timers per lane. One of the timers will actually be activating the plunger, which will be a fail safe on the touch pad. while both timers actually stopwatches. And as Doug mentioned, we hand write the time on a sheet of paper, and hopefully amongst the touch of the swimmer, the fail safe, two electronic times, we'll be able to provide a time. If all four fail, I guess we could go to the coaches, or maybe like a spectator who's really involved.
Yeah. Well, it looks like we're going to get started now. They're starting to announce the teams. So why don't we go ahead and give you the lineups for the first event. So as we mentioned, they're starting to announce the public address announcers announcing the teams and captains right now. And again, from just recapping real quickly, the head coach from the Midland High team is Coach Buffy Hall, and we'll give you some background on her as we get going. And her assistant coach is Pat Welter, who's also the head coach of the Midland Boys Swim team. And then from Dow High, we have Renee Allen, who's the head coach of the girls, and Carl Chili Smith, who is the assistant coach, but also the assistant coach for the boys team. So a lot of dedicated coaches to the sport of swimming here locally. And as we get started, I'm going to go ahead and give just the lineup for the first event for those on the line. In heat number one of the girls' 200-yard medley relay, in lane one will be Dow High. And swimming in that relay team will be Leanne Hogue, Maddie Downhauer, Emily Dean, and Allie Jaster. In lane two from Dow High, and in some of these preliminary events, sometimes the strict lane requirements won't be met. They'll actually be Dow High and Midland High swimmers. But in the final heat, they'll be pretty much strictly in the allocated lanes, Midland in 2, 4, and 6, and Dow in 1, 3, and 5. And in some of the preliminary heats, just to keep the meet efficient, there will be some crossover. So in this first heat, in lane 2 from Dow High, will be Isabella Kempel, Brittany Bauer, Brittany Ammerman, and Carson Sass. In lane 3 from Midland High will be Rachel Crowley, Fina Achilles, Deju Trevinas, and Holly Stouffer. In lane 4 from Dow High will be Anna Alsup, Abby Cook, Jenna Lee, and Emily Schulteis. And in lane 5 from Dow High will be Veronica Matthews, Annika Thorsten, Jackie Lee, and Brooke Schultz. And we're to the starter. One of the challenges tonight will be to get a good quiet start with the crowd today. Should be approaching the box here shortly.
Midland High lane 4, D relay. Lane 5, Midland High, E relay. And lane 6, Midland, F relay. Please be quiet for the start.
And here we go. First heat, 200-yard medley relay.
I think there appears to be a discrepancy of the relay team that should be in lane 2 program versus those that are actually lined up. We have a Dow team, but I think they're claiming there's a Midland team missing maybe. One can imagine when you've got four swimmers per lane, six lanes, multiple heats, as Doug mentioned, getting everyone where they need to be so that one, we can actually account for them during the time. This is not a given.
And it looks like they may be changing some lane assignments. So it does look like Midland High now will be swimming in lane 2. And that the team from Dow High is moving to lane 3. But we'll check that.
Thank you.
And it's just important that the lane assignments match with the computer program, because like we said, they can make those changes pretty quickly now, but sometimes it does take an additional minute if there is a change.
Doug, does it look like they're going to be using all six lanes here? Or?
Well, there should be only five lanes in this first heat. So.
Okay.
And they're off. And Kurt, just to be sure for the viewers at home, they did switch basically. Lane two is now Midland, and I believe that's the Rachel Crowley, Dean Archeles, Deju Gervinas, and Holly Stoker in lane two, and then Dow High is in lane three. And this is pretty much an all-out sprint of each stroke, so it's a very fast relay, fast and short.
As you can hear, the shakers are already going. The crowd's starting to get into this.
And we're off into the breaststroke, and you'll see in lane three, Dow High's lane three and five are pretty close battling, followed closely by the two teams in middle lane. The one thing about having very large teams is you can field some very strong relays with the depth, because a lot of these girls are always fighting to get into these various relay teams. So after the breaststroke, it looks like Dow High is in the lead in the butterfly, and all the butterflies now are hitting the water.
The butterfly in the lead in lane three is Brittany Emmerman. She'll be one of our seniors tonight from Dow on it. If I'm not mistaken.
Yep, that's Brittany. And here we come for the anchor leg for the leading team in lane three. Looks like that would be Carson Sachs. Nice finish by Dow High, and you'll see their times will show up on the backboard. The winning time here is 1:57.50. And you'll see on the board the place will correspond with the lane number. So in this case, lane three was in first place, lane five close behind in second, as the other teams finish up. So I'll help set up the second heat now. This will be the finals in lane one from Midland. It'll be Taylor Fagan, Caroline Jassen, Bryn Rode, and Gabby Holman. In lane two from Midland Dow will be Katie Burkett. I'm sorry, from Midland will be Katie Burkett, Stephanie Lynch, Delaney Randall, and Anna Schulteis. And in lane three from Dow High will be Hannah Jacobs, Kelly Ballard, Maggie Dooley, and Kaylee Niederstadt. In lane four from Midland will be Emily Crush, Natalie Halpin, Allie Kiekafer, and Catherine Veneer. In lane five from Midland Dow, Maddie Allen, Rachel Schneider, Alyssa Henning, and Serena Dinder Fleming. In fact, that sounds like a Midland team to me. And in lane six from Midland will be Brittany Duford, Julia Quinn, Olivia Barber, and Danya McDonald. Yeah, and I think they're having the issue again, Kurt, that according to the program, some of the lane assignments seem to be off by one. So, I believe.
I see what you're talking about. Yeah.
Yep. So we'll try to track that as we go. But definitely lane one will be Midland Dow, and lane two will be Midland. I think everything else was correct.
So at this point, they've actually asked the backstrokers to enter the water. At this point, they're asking them to relax, if that's possible, before they compete, as they sort out their issues, and then they'll commence in shortly.
Yeah. Yeah, because I think I see some of the issues looking at our sheet. We have predominantly Midland teams in the sea.
Oh, my goodness.
And I think they're just getting it straightened away. Yeah, especially for technical difficulties that aren't part of the telecast. This is part of the actual running of the meet, so it's definitely important that they get this ferreted away. Squared away before the meet continues.
No, it's interesting. I'm just hoping, as I look at the timing board there, that lane one timing system is working. old habits die hard. You want to see a clean start and a clean finish.
So I think we can go to our backup area here too. What I can do, is tell you, basically I think what will happen is in lane one from Dow High, I'm going to go ahead and reread what I'm seeing out on the pool deck, because I think there was a discrepancy just on the relays on some of the entries. Yeah, and so in lane one, I believe this will be the correct lineup. In lane one for Dow, it will be Holly Young, Tiffany Nestorek, Katie White, and Lauren McLean. In lane five for Dow will be Anna Alsop, Abby Cook, Jenna Lee, and Emily Schulteis. And in lane one for Dow will be Hannah Jacobs, Kelly Ballard, Maggie Dooley, and Kaylee Niederstad. And then we'll get the corrected lane assignments for Midland High here shortly. Well, while we're waiting, we mentioned that a lot of the coaches have a long background, so why don't we start with the head coach from Midland High, Coach Buffy Hall. And I think we're going to get started, so we'll hold off and make the race the priority. I think they have the teams in the right order now. There we go. A very good start. Again, looks like a good start off the blocks with a really strong turn by the backstroker from Dow High. That looks like Hannah Jacobs taking the lead. Right behind them, though, in lane five, is the team from Midland. I believe that's Emily Fresh, followed by Natalie Hatham, who just dove in for the breaststroke. As you'll see, sometimes the races go beyond just the first place, but there seems to be a good battle in this race for second place right now between lanes three and two. I'm sorry, four and five. And now the butterfly is into the water. Swimming butterfly for Dow High, and this track is Maggie Dooley out in front in first place. And it looks like now that Dow in lane 5 has moved ahead. This is a very close race now for second place. It looks like Dow will get the first, but the battle here will be for second place between Midland and the Dow IB team. Boyd Lane. Five is really coming out of nowhere here, and oh, almost caught her at the end. Good finish. Very good swim.
I think we may have had an issue with the timing system there. Just looking at the times. Maybe not.
Yeah, so in a case like that, then the judges will basically set the places. So if there is an abstract on the display board, it's taken care of. So, but in first place, that was the team from Dow High. And again, that was Hannah Jacobs, Kelly Ballard, Maggie Dooley, and Kaylee Niederstadt. And in second place, actually, from Dow High was Anna Alsop, Abby Cook, Jenna Lee, and Emily Schulteis. In third place was the team from Dow High, which was Emily Crush, Natalie Halpin, Holly Keekaper, and Catherine Veneer.
This is what I'm observing is Coach Gary Strickler, the girls' coach who retired a year ago, is back on the duty. He's replacing some of the cabling to enable the timing system to work properly.
Oh, excellent. Yep. Gary's an ex-engineer, so I'm sure he'll have the problem fixed in no time. As we go on to the next event, which will be the 200 freestyle, and taking a quick glance at the first heat. This heat looks to be all Dow High swimmers in this first preliminary heat. So starting from lane 1 will be Olivia Montgomery, lane 2, Abby Cook, lane 3, Anne-Marie Moulinar, lane 4, Morgan Herschel, and lane 5, Amy Berry. Now the 200-yard freestyle is 8 lengths of the pool in the freestyle stroke. In freestyle, it's generally swam African crawl or overhand crawl stroke. But technically, in freestyle, you can swim any of the other three strokes if you want to. But generally, people will use the crawl stroke as the predominant stroke. But every once in a while, someone who has a stronger offstroke is allowed to swim it as long as they don't change and follow the rules of the stroke.
And I'm noticing here that in this particular heat, we have all Dow High swimmers. In the program, they're listed with an X for exhibition. So this is a unique opportunity for the coach to get a time on the swimmer in the event. So this is also a chance for the swimmers to participate.
Yeah. And we'll get into that right after the start of this event. And they're in the water. And that's a good point. In discussing the meet beforehand with Coach Allen from Dow High, she planned on using this event to give some girls opportunities to swim strokes they normally don't swim. Or if they haven't swam them very much, but they need an important time, tonight will be the night that they get a chance to do that. And so when coaches agree to run extra exhibition heats, it gives both teams time to get times for these swimmers that are updated. Because the changes from the beginning of the season to the end of the season be pretty dramatic, especially at this time of the season when they're well-conditioned and really ready to go. So because there's limited meets, not every swimmer gets to swim every event, every meet. So but sometimes it's just to get an opportunity to swim it to see if they can post the best time. And we'll track along as the meet goes on for swimmers that beat their personal best times. These are the times we have listed in front of us. And we'll try to make note for both improved swims as well as the people that happened to place first or second in the race.
And as the girls like to do, they are at the end of the lane actually supporting their swimmers in the water. So when the girls are not actually participating in the event, they like to continue to cheer on the team and provide moral support.
We'll have two heats of this event, so there'll be this heat and then there'll be a final heat. Again, right now, good battle between Anne-Marie Molinar and Morgan Hershill for first place.
This event, it's kind of a long sprint.
Yeah.
And so as you actually progress through the event, as you get into like the length 5, 6, 7, 8, really test the endurance as well as the sprinting capability of the swimmer. It's kind of a character builder.
Yep. Oh, a nice close-up of the swimmers there going after it for first place. You'll see as they come into the turn can be a very important element. All right. So in this case, we had lane 4, which was Morgan Hershill just touching out senior Anne-Marie Molinar. Good race. And it does seem for both swimmers to be a personal best time. So congratulations to both of those swimmers. Now we'll move into the final of the 200 free. And you'll notice after every event, the swimmers will be allotted a single length to warm down. You know, due to the tight quarters of the pool, some pools will have separate warm down lanes, but we're not afforded that this evening, so the swimmers are given one length to basically to warm down to help prepare for their next event. In heat 2, in lane 1, I think we're going to need to get updated. So in lane 1, Delaney Randall. Lane 2, Sarah Brandstadt. Lane 3, Chelsea Fenton. Lane 4, Megan Pisarczyk. In lane 5, Catherine Grenier. In lane 6, Rachel Schneider.
It looks like we might have actually reversed like odds and evens.
Yep. Yeah, this might be a continuing conundrum. I'm curious if there's an updated heat sheet that we need to get for the race. We'll get a short break here in a minute and we'll be able to check that.
Looks like they're testing the timing system at this time.
Okay.
So the timing system when the official says swimmers take your mark go, you'll hear the beep, which is also signaled by a light. Since the light travels faster than sound, the timers will actually actuate their watches when they see the light based on the starter start. Swimmers will then initiate the race, jump into the pool, and make their way. At the very end, the swimmers will stop the race by touching the pad. The programming system is such that based on the event and the timing system, the pads are sophisticated to know the number of lengths. So for example, if a swimmer swam beyond the number of lengths required for that event, the timing system would actually stop and actually capture the correct time for the swimmer at that point in time. So it's kind of a built-in fail-safe when the timing system is functional. So this is can be typical. You hope and pray that the timing system is nice and smooth. But occasionally, you have to work out the glitches before we actually reach that stride. But as Doug mentioned earlier, that we have backup timers, adults and students that are providing that behind the lanes. And if the timing system were to fail fully, an old-fashioned electronic time would still work. And as Doug was alluding back in the day, it was actually an analog watch.
And I'm going to make an attempt here shortly to get an updated heat sheet, because obviously they've changed it, so I want to make sure we get the girls announced correctly. So I'm going to leave the floor to you, Kurt, for a second, and I'm going to get the updated sheet so we can do the announcements according to the actual plan.
So again, this is the 200 free. This is the final heat of the 200 free. Dow High swimming in lane 1, 3, and 5. Midland High swimming in lane 2, 4, and 6. As Doug mentioned, the important thing is that we actually get the computer system aligned with the swimmer so that we can capture the timing, which feeds directly into the scoring system. It looks early on after the first 50 that Dow was out to a early lead, but very, very close as you can see. Again, this is a sprint, so the swimmers are turning over their arms and they have a rapid kick. So the swimmers are actually reaching the midway of the race. They're actually at the 100-yard mark of the 200-yard race. They've made the turn. As Doug mentioned, the turns are important. The swimmers have been practicing throughout the season to fine-tune their technique. The technique as they pull their hand through the water, their tempo, their ratio, tightness of the turns, kicking in and out of the turns, when to breathe. Getting oxygen, as you might imagine, is quite important. And again, it looks like we have a couple Dow swimmers that are leading this event. But it looks like the Midland is right in the thick of it there. So different swimmers have different paces and different levels of stamina. And so the Midland team is like right in there. It's the exciting finish here as we go into the final turn. And as you'll see here shortly, very, very tight race in the 200-yard freestyle as the winning time.
One, Sarah Brandstatt. I'm sorry, actually. It looks like in lane one, Sarah Brandstatt touched out lane four. Very close race.
Finishing first in lane three, Jessica Middleton.
Very close finish. Sarah Brandstatt touched out for number two. So Kurt, you should be smiling, and he's smiling in the booth today. So nice swim by Sarah. Best time. So now with great relief, we can announce the next event. Now in the next event, there will only be one heat, and this is the 200 individual medley. And unlike the relay, the order is quite different. The swimmers will swim two lengths of each in a stroke in this order, butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and then finish with the freestyle. And in lane one from Dow High will be Katie White. In lane two, from Midland, Maddie Allen. In lane three, Elizabeth Maraskin from Dow High. Lane four, Natalie Halpin, Midland. Lane five, Kelly Ballard from Dow. And lane six, Stephanie Lynch from Midland High.
I'm afraid we might be actually wrestling with a little bit more timing issues here. As I look at the experts in the building,
Lane six.
There we go.
Yep, there they got it. So sometimes a pad will not stop, I guess, and they need to reset that. But again, the time's still collected by the backup means, so it's still electronically captured.
Sometimes the swimmer, depending upon how they touch the wall, if they grab the top of the pad, although I think the top of the pad is designed to turn it off, it's a little less sensitive, and sometimes they will fail to stop the electronic timing system. But it looks like we've got a complete deck of times, but as Doug mentioned, the backup times will be used, and the timing system, the computer system, is set up to actually look for an abnormal delta flag times for review.
And here we go into the 200 individual medley. Again, only one heat. This will be the final heat. This is an event where swimmers that usually have a lot of experience swimming, because it requires good technique and endurance in all four strokes. Start. I see lanes 1, 3, and 5 out to the early lead on the butterfly. Right now, senior Elizabeth Maraskin seems to be in first place from Dow High, followed closely by Katie White and Kelly Ballard. You see the two-hand touch going into the butterfly route. See very close race all the way around into the backstroke. Usually what makes or breaks this event is the next event, the breaststroke. Breaststrokers generally do very well in the IM. It's the longest duration event, and so a good breaststroker can make headway. And we'll see how this goes this time. So right now in first place, lane 3. Second place, lane 1, and then right behind in lane 5, and then followed by lanes 2 and 6 and 4 from Midland. And again, Emily Maraskin out first, but a good challenge right now for second place between the two Dow High swimmers.
While the swimmers swim the breaststroke, they can clearly see down in the pool, and it's nice to see the swimmer supporting the swimmers, kind of give them a little bit of morale boost there.
Pretty much needed on this event. It gets pretty tiring switching muscle groups after every hard sprint 50. And here they come into the freestyle. And as they come in, it looks like Elizabeth Maraskin will take this one. Elizabeth is a senior and a captain of the Dow High swim team. And coming in with a solid time of 2:29.27. Followed by second Kelly Ballard and then Katie White. One of the things I'm noticing today a little bit, Kurt, is you can tell this is the time of the year pre-taper where the swimmers are getting their maximum training in. So some of the times are a little bit slower tonight than what we'd normally see, but that's pretty normal for this event before they go into a period to muscle recovery on both teams. And I know both teams have been training very hard to try to get qualifying times in the upcoming Valley meet.
Their focus in the pool has been exceptional. Both teams have been engaged in morning practice and after school practice. And also a dry land weight exercise program as well. As Doug mentioned, they've been training hard, and this is the period where they will start to transition and start to build in more and more rest as they work their way towards the final championship at the league.
Yep. And again, it looks like they're still working on the lane one timer. Was a little bit off on that one as well. So eventually it'll work out. But let's go on to the sprint event. And there's going to be many heats of this event. The 50-yard free. And in the first heat, in lane one from Midland, Hayden Rice. Lane two from Midland, Whitney Duford. Lane three from Midland, Rachel Crowley. Lane four from Midland, Holly Stouffer. And lane five from Midland, Fina Achilles. One thing we know for sure is that Midland will win this heat. And again, this is one of six heats. The 50 freestyle is a full-out sprint and is a very popular event for a lot of swimmers. This is about basically cranking it up and going. Good finish there in lane two, in lanes three and four. And it looks like lane three, Rachel Crowley just touching out her teammate, Holly Stouffer on this one. And here they come in. You'll see very close, heads up. And you can see right at the end, just a slight touch out, just right over the top. That finish is so important. It can mean the difference between first and second. And in this case, a difference of 1/10 of a second.
And the swimmers practice the final touch, the angle of the hand hitting the wall, hand through the air, through the water.
Yeah, the difference can be a lot of swimmers, when they're first learning, they touch it with a flat hand, and then as they mature, they start touching with their fingertips, and an event like this can make the world of difference between first and second. So in heat two, 50 free, in lane one, Caitlin Carr from Dow High, lane two from Midland, Carolyn Jasen. Lane three from Midland, Annika Thorson. Lane four from Midland, Olivia Barber. Lane five for Dow, Lauren Aganowski. And lane six, also from Midland High, Maggie Dietz. And again, as we go through the meet, we'll try to point out various seniors from both teams as they move forward. And it is, again, a night honoring a lot of the seniors and all the long period and effort that they've earned over their careers in swimming. Winner in that heat was lane three, Annika Thorson from Midland Down. Good swim, Annika. And that was a personal best time as well for Annika, so double congratulations there. Next heat, heat three, Leanne Hogue, lane one from Midland, Dow. Lane two, Julia Powers from Midland. Lane three, Allie Jaster, Dow. Lane four from Midland, Bryn Rode. Lane five, also from Dow, Isabel Kempel. And lane six, Tehu Saringa, Cernavis. Srinivas, thank you.
Although a short race, a lot of technique is packed into this two-length event. From the start, as they work their way through the water, the turn, and as we've been pointing out, the approach to the finish. Breathe, don't breathe.
First place here, again, 31.98 from lane five, Isabel Kempel. And again, a personal best time. So congratulations to Isabel. You'll see her coming in. Nice stretch into the wall. Very nice swim. Close finish. Second place in lane three was Allie Jaster. So in heat four, the 50 free, lane one, Brittany Ammerman, Dow. Lane two, Brittany Duford, Midland. Lane three, Brooke Schultz, Dow. Lane four, Donna McDonald, Midland. Lane five, Jackie Lee, Dow. And lane six, I believe it's Serena. Dittenberg Fleming from Midland.
The Midland swimmer in lane 6 is right out there.
Yep. Oh, this will be a close finish as well. Coming into the wall. Lane 3. Congratulations, Brooke Schultz, a sophomore from Midland Dow, with a time of 30.03, so a slight drop and a personal best time. Seeing a lot of personal bests in this 53, Kurt.
This event is affectionately known as a splash and dash.
So we'll keep cranking through the 50-yard frees. They come very fast. So this is now Heat 5, Maggie Dooley, Lane 1, Dow. Julia Quinn, Lane 2, Midland. Kaylee Niederstedt, Lane 3, Midland, Dow. Lane 4, Gabby Honan from Midland. Lane 5, Anna Alsop from Midland, Dow. And Lane 6, Taylor Fagan from Midland. Three seniors in this event. Lane 2, Julia Quinn from Midland. And Anna Alsop from Midland Dow, and Taylor Fagan in lane 6 from Midland. As you see, the times are getting progressively faster per heat, and no exception in this case. So the winner in lane 5, I believe that is... Yeah, I guess the timer came off. Yep. So we'll get a replay, and we can actually see for ourselves here. Very close race between lanes 3 and 5, and you'll see, looks like lane 5 to me, but lane 3 looks like they had the touch-up, but very close, 27.89. Kaylee Niederstedt from Midland Dow. Just touching out Anna Alsop, senior from Dow High at a 27.97. And in the finals now of the 50-yard freestyle, lane 1, Emily Schulteis, lane 2, Anna Schulteis. Interesting story there. These are sisters, but they compete for two different high schools. So Anna Schulteis is a senior from Midland, and Emily Schulteis, a sophomore from Midland Dow. Lane 3, Sarah Syed. Lane 4, Courtney Kaiser. Lane 5, Jenna Lee from Dow. And lane 6, Melissa Hemming. Hemming from Midland.
Wow.
This is going to be a very close race between lane 3 and 5. Jenna Lee is the senior in lane 5. Looks like she might touch her out. No, actually, dated at the very end. So Sarah Syed got first place.
Oh my gosh, by 0.01.
By 0.01, very close finish. Lane 5, Jenna Lee in second. And in lane, in third place, from lane 1, in Dow was Emily Schulteis. Fourth place from Midland was lane 2, Anna Schulteis. So the Schulteis bragging rights, at least for this meet in a very close race, goes to younger daughter Emily Schulteis, who just touched out her sister Anna. Very close race.
I think at this point we're going to prepare for the senior night.
Yeah, I think so. They're going to move to senior night activities after the 53, and then we'll move into the diving. Yeah. So I think, like I said, they'll be setting up for senior night activities. And so we've completed the first half of swimming for the meet tonight with good performances from both teams. Dow High seems to be taking more of the first places tonight, but a lot of solid races from top to bottom. Even saw a sister swim at the end. That was nice, and we'll try to point those things out as the meet goes along. And now once the timer and the lineups things are straightened away, it looks like we're going to have smooth sailing. We'll be re-entering for coming back for the diving competition, and I believe for the diving competition we have a total of 6 divers competing. And so just a few reminders. We'll take some time to announce the cable. Go ahead, Kurt.
Sure. You are watching this Midland High versus Dow High swim meet on MPS-TV 190 on Charter or Channel 99 on AT&T U-verse in Midland. This event will be shown at the following dates and times. Wednesday, October 21st at 12:45 p.m. Thursday, October 22nd at 1:15 p.m. Friday, October 23rd at 1:15 p.m. Saturday, October 24th at 1 p.m. For more dates and times or to stream this program online, check the Midland Public Schools website at midlandps.org. The coverage of the swim meet is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on Saturday, November 14th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. to start your training. Learn about MCTV and how to become a TV producer and get hands-on training to become a volunteer. The cost is just $45, which includes your first-year access membership fee. Call 837-3474 or come down to MCTV Studios in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. Learn more at www.cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV or follow us on Facebook. Every year, MCTV recognizes the people and organizations that create programming for the community of Midland. Join us at this year's Honors Night celebration on November 19th at 6:30 p.m. Ceremony will be held at Creative 360, which is located at 1517 Bayless Street in Midland. Please help us honor those who volunteer and work hard to bring you programs like this one. Light refreshments will be provided.
Well, okay, and so we're going to go ahead and you can see they're lining up for senior night and some of the discussions with the coaches, they're going to do something very new this year. They're going to recognize the Midland High seniors before diving and then the Dow High seniors after diving. But one thing both teams agreed to is that as the seniors were recognized as they passed through to meet their parents at the end of the pool, that both teams wanted to line up for each other. So as mentioned, many of these swimmers through age group swimming and recreational swimming know each other, and they both wanted to take part in the event. So they'll be congratulated by both teams during the announcements, and they'll do various announcements on the various seniors. So we're gonna turn it over to the public announcer for this section.
They will introduce all of our seniors.
Welcome back to the Midland Dow High. We're going to go into the diving competition. The first diver will be from Midland, Daphne Siderna. They're asking for quiet in the audience. And as we go, we'll announce the dives. If it's quiet enough, you'll probably pick up the...
First dive, Midland High, Daphne. Dive number 41.
Daphne is a freshman from Midland High for her first dive. First dive. Started very nice first dive. So it's amazing the progress. This is Amanda Klein from Dow High in her first dive. Amanda's also a senior from Dow High. See on the replay, very good scores. 5, 4, 4.5. Sarah Wing from Midland, junior. Scores ranging from 6 and 5 and 5.5.
Riley Davis, dive number 5, 2, 2, 1, back, 1 somersault, half twist to the 3 position, degree of difficulty 1.7.
So this will be Riley Davis, from Dow. He's a freshman. Last diver in the first round is Kayla Patnode from Midland. She's a senior.
Diving. You know, she has a background in gymnastics, if I'm not mistaken. She's recognized for being a mentor to the other divers.
Dive in a tough position. Degree of difficulty 1.4. difficulty 1.2.
And I think she did pretty good at the recent Tri-Cities meet, David. Top three finisher, I believe, second place. We're now into the second round. Going back to Daphne Sederna, ninth grader from Midland. Forward dive, top position. Scores 3, 2.5, and 3.
Daphne's noted she decided to begin diving in October. She said, I wanted to try diving, and she gave it a go. She now has 3 dives, and tonight she's diving exhibition, so we've seen 2 or 3.
Okay. That's part of the challenge with diving. You have to compete in so many dives, and you have to be able to do them all to be able to compete. So it's great that she can do a full slate for this evening. This is Taylor Harvey from Midland.
Taylor started with the swimming dive program in swimming, and then 2 weeks into the season this year, she asked Coach Hall if she could try diving. And she started diving exhibition because she didn't have 6 dives. This is her 3rd meet diving 6 dives with a full slate. She now has 11 dives, and she's qualified to dive at the Valleys.
Oh, excellent. Now the senior from Dow, Amanda Klein. See, that was a reverse dive. This is where you actually have to put your feet out away from the board. It's one of the more challenging dives that you can do as a diver, because you, as you'll see on the replay, as she launches, her feet move forward with her head back towards the board. And visually, that's a difficult challenge to see how high and close to the board you can get. But of course, staying away from the board for safety purposes. Nice dive. Sarah Wing from Midland, her second dive. That was a back dive.
So Sarah was in her second year of diving in Midland High. She was previously a gymnast. She did very, very well at the Tri-City Championship about a month ago. She took 3rd. And she broke 200 for the first time last week at the Alma Mount Pleasant meet, which is a milestone for the divers.
Riley Davis from Dow, her second dive. Two somersaults on the pike. And this will be Kayla Petnode. One of the more difficult dives with a little higher degree of difficulty than the ones we've seen so far. Do the 2 somersaults, you need very high arc and very good. It's the classic pike position with a good entry. Nice.
Yeah, exceptional dive.
Now we're going into the 3rd round of diving. Starting off again is Daphne from Midland. To know that the diving programs at both schools have been growing, and Kurt, I know they had some new coaching help this year.
That's true. Coach Jill Yatterman volunteers and coaches both teams, both Dow and Midland. Jill is a graduate from the University of Toledo, where she dove for 4 years. Jill has a gymnastics and diving background. Her dad is currently the head gymnastics coach at Central Michigan University. Jill dove for Mount Pleasant High School. We are so thankful that Jill has been able to help us out. Jill has been a great addition to our program. We hope that she can help the boys this winter and with the girls again next fall, just becoming a recognized leader in the diving program in Midland.
So that was Taylor Hardy and her third dive. But yeah, it looks like she'll be helping out with the boys coming up, so it's nice to see some of these accomplished divers go back and then come back to the community and help out the programs here.
As Doug mentioned earlier in the telecast, that we share the pool, both programs, and the diving as well.
So the pool's heavily used. It's hard to get time sometimes. And so these athletes have to be flexible in their schedule and come when they can get the pool, but they use it a lot. This is Amanda's third dive. Amanda Fine from Dow. Forward dive. Nice entry. Now Sarah Wing from Midland, our only junior diver. Wow, very high scores on that dive. You can see why. Nice clean with a good entry. Scores of 7, very high scores. Now we move to Riley Davis from Dow. Another back dive. Another reverse dive for Daphne's next dive. I'm sorry, for Kayla's next dive. Again, with the feet lead the board ahead of the head. Very challenging dive. It's the hardest type of dive for divers in general. Because again, they have to lay back towards the board.
If you get the fourth round of diving, Taylor
really good height.
Dive number 103 forward, 1.1 somersault, tough position. Degree of difficulty.
Going into the fourth round of diving, so with Daphne's fourth round. Daphne Soderna from Midland. Divers have different rules of thumbs and where they want to put their favorite dives. And, sometimes they save the best for last, other times they save the most challenging dives for last.
In talking to the coaches before the meet tonight, we learned that prior to high school, there really aren't any diving opportunities for kids in Midland. Gymnasts make good divers because they have experience doing flips. In talking to one of the girl divers, she told us that gymnastics and diving are different because the gymnasts land on their feet and the divers have a hands first anchor. So diving is difficult to learn.
And that was Amanda Clyde's fourth dive from Dow. Scores in the 4.5 area. Forward 1.5 dive. Sarah Wing. As you mentioned, Sarah was one of these converted gymnasts. And she also did very well at Midland, did very well at the Tri-City meet, taking third place, with Kayla taking second.
And as Doug mentioned, the shared resource, the pool here. Apparently the other pool in the community that has a diving board is the Midland Country Club. So some of the athletes will actually participate both, but primarily here, and as Doug said, flexibility is the key.
And here's Riley Davis again for her fourth dive.
As you can hear, the swimmers take great pride in their diving.
Yeah, that was a very nice dive. Over the season, it's great, the improvement that we've seen from the first meet. Now the divers can do more dives, but also are accomplishing the dives better. Yeah. And again, this will be Kayla Patnod from Midland High. Mostly fours on that dive, but again, a dive with a pretty high degree of difficulty. Now going into the next round, Daphne Sederna, Midland. Scores, 4.5 across the board. It's Amanda's fifth dive. Again, nice to see two senior divers, Amanda Klein from Dow, Kayla Patnod from Midland. Both diving very well today. And we're back. Six and a half sides.
Next dive is Sarah Wing, Midland High. Dive number 302.
Nice line of water. Almost not a splash at all. Very nice entry by Amanda. Sarah Wing's next dive. Today, Coach, to be pretty close, I think, to finish here.
Exactly. Excellent. Keep pushing forward.
And a great example, reverse dive. Single. Nice entry. Good dive by Sarah. Now Riley Davis from Dow. Thank you. forward dive. Again, the challenge with the inward dive is you see the board as you come down. And the divers can tend to control their distance from the board and get a good, nice line vertically in the water.
Hold on, get your heart rate up watching some of those dives.
This is Caleb Hatnode from Midland. Kayla gets a lot of degree of difficulty points in her dives.
Six and a half.
Very difficult dive, but a nice entry. Going into the last round here, I think right now, it's close, but I believe the lead is probably by Kayla Patnod, but we'll see in this last round if she can hold on. Last round of diving, Daphne's last dive, Daphne Sederna from Midland. Solid scores for her last dive. Fives across the board.
Well, I just have to comment that the board is seriously springy for her to stand there so still. Impressive.
Taylor Harvey's last dive. Again, Taylor from Midland High. Freshman. I'm sorry, it's Amanda. Amanda Klein from Dow. Had him out of order. Again, Sarah's last dive will be a double somersault in tuck position. Again, any degree of difficulty over two is a more difficult dive. I think you'll notice it when she takes off the double rotation. And then Riley Davis, her last dive of the evening. Another inward dive. Finish for Riley.
Yeah, absolutely solid.
Yeah, pretty and now Kayla's going to wrap up the diving. Another 2.2 degree of difficulty dive. I believe this is a 1.5 somersault. But in the inward, which makes it difficult. Very nice dive. 1.5 is a lot lower, but when it's above a degree of difficulty, she's in an inward position. I think she nailed it.
4.5, 6.5. This concludes the diving.
We'll have the results of the diving shortly. So Kurt, good round of diving. So they're going to calculate the scores. I'm sure they'll announce the winner here shortly. I think it was pretty close. This could be a first place for Midland High maybe in this event. Kayla was very strong. We had, as you could see, some of the more difficult dives of the evening.
Excellent participation from both schools, Midland and Dow. Six total divers, four representing Midland and two representing Dow. From freshmen all the way through the seniors. Doug pointed out we had two seniors diving tonight. And obviously they took great pride, as do all the divers, but great pride in their last Midland Dow meet. The divers, I see that they're actually helping put on the harness to raise the board. So very helpful. so springy out there.
And hopefully they'll announce the diving here, and then you'll see the teams are also now setting up for the other senior night festivities, for this time for the Dow High seniors. And again, both teams lining up to congratulate one another. So again, through the halfway point of the meet now, including diving, a good meet all the way around. So hopefully in the second half of the meet, we'll a little more highlights of backgrounds of some of the coaches and some of their histories coming up. And we'll try to get you the results before we take a quick break during the Dow High Senior festivities. But again, crowded pool tonight. Plenty of swimmers on deck and family. And good evening for all. And if they don't, if they're not able to announce diving before the festivities, we can always, we'll collect the results and announce it when we return from the break. So we're going to play it by ear here for a second, and then if we go to a break, we'll return. So just, we can talk a little real quickly about opportunities for MCTV.
You are watching this Midland High versus Dow High swim meet on MPS-TV 190 on Charter, or Channel 99 on AT&T U-verse in Midland. This event will be showing at the following dates and times. Wednesday, October 21st at 12:45 p.m., Thursday, October 22nd at 1:15 p.m., Friday, October 23rd at 1:15 p.m., and Saturday, October 24th at 1 p.m.
And it looks like they're going to go ahead and start the senior activities, so we'll announce the diving results hopefully when we return.
Like to thank her parents for supporting her through everything. Way to go.
Thank you.
Well, welcome back to the second half of the Midland Dow 2015 swim meet. And just to recap, we do have the diving results, and then we're going to be jumping right into the 100 butterfly. So we're going to go ahead and announce the 100 fly first, and then we'll give you some updated scores. This will be the 100-yard butterfly, first heat of two. And in lane one from Midland Dow is Olivia Montgomery. Lane two from Midland Dow is Abby Cook. Lane three from Midland Dow is Anne Marie Molinar. Lane four from Midland, I'm sorry, announcing the wrong event. Let's go. Lane two from Midland Dow, Brittany Ammerman. Lane three from Midland Dow, Sarah Brandstatt. Lane four from Midland Dow, Lauren McLean. And lane five from Midland Dow, Emily Dean. Again, the 100-yard butterfly. And as they swim this, we can announce the diving results. In sixth place from Midland was Daphne Sederna. In fifth place from Midland was Taylor Harvey. In fourth place from Dow was Riley Davis. In third place from Dow was Amanda Klein. And a very close finish in second place was Kayla Patnode from Midland. And in first place from Midland High School was Sarah Wing. And it was a very close within 1 point. So Sarah Wing finished with 204 points and Kayla Patnode with 203. So congratulations to the divers. And our halftime score is Dow High 55 and Midland 23. And on the completion of the first heat, it looks like first place was in lane three. And that would have been from Midland Dow, Sarah Brandstatt, with a time of 1:13:32.22. Now the final heat from Dow in lane one will be Megan Herschel. In lane two from Midland will be Delaney Randall. In lane three from Midland Dow, Maggie Dooley. In lane four, Allie Keycaper. In lane five from Midland Dow, Chelsea Fenton. And in lane six from Midland, Stephanie Lynch. Again, four lengths to the butterfly, only two heats. This is one of the more strenuous events, butterfly being the most demanding physically of the four events.
I think it's like the one event where the body comes out of the water.
Yeah, oh yeah, it's very hard. It's amazing on the diving, finished within 1 point. Between the two Midland. Yeah, very close.
203.
Yeah. Second heat of the 100 butterfly.
I noticed before the diving that they actually set up special video equipment to capture all the dives so that the coach can go back and review. But we're in the final heat of the 100 butterfly with Dow High in the odd lanes, 1, 3, and 5.
Yeah, very close race all around there. Allie Keycaper and Maggie Dooley battling it out for first place. And it also looks like Chelsea Fenton has just moved in to second place. It's going to be a close finish. This is where the strength part really sets in the second 50, Kurt.
They're driving those legs, trying to get the body up. Up out and down the pool. Nice swim.
Good swim by Maggie Dooley, 107.73 for first place. In second place, looks like Chelsea Fenton in lane 5, 109.79. And in third place, in lane one, also from Dow, was Morgan Herschel. In fourth place, lane four, Allie Keycaper from Midland. Now we're going to have quite a number of heats. Looks like four heats of the 100-yard freestyle. And the first heat is all Midland swimmers. Lane one, Hayden Rice. Lane two, Whitney Duford. Lane three, Olivia Barber. Lane four, Maggie Dietz. And lane five, Finya Achilles. This is the 100-yard freestyle, first of four heats.
So as we watch the first heat of the 100 free, we're going to take a moment to review some of the accomplishments from the Midland High School swimming program girls this season. Notably, they had six girls attending the MISCA MISCA meet, which is a invitational where the swimmers have to qualify. So it's not a straight qualifying time, but it's a very, very fast qualifying time. So it's by invitation, and six girls going, that's a notable achievement. The 200 medley relay team of Emily Crush, Alexis Alig, Ali Kiefer, and Anna Schultheis. The 200 free relay team of Alexis, Courtney, Ali, and Catherine Vernier. And then 53 and 100 breast with Alexis. Alexis has dropped 10 seconds in the 100 breaststroke this year, and the coach wanted to call that out as a notable achievement, which four lengths, 10 seconds, a significant improvement. Midland High has won all of their dual meets besides Heritage at this point in time. Midland High has also won the Midland Invitational. Midland High finished fourth at the Tri-Cities. I think out of eight teams. And Midland High is hoping for a third place finish at the Valley. So their preparation, their training, to put them in that position to compete.
Great. And as the first heat winds up, first place in that heat was Maggie Dietz from Midland High School. She's a junior, and her time was 1:19.19, which is looks to be a personal best for Maggie. So congratulations to her. In heat two, from lane one, from Dow, will be Caitlin Carr. In lane two, Bryn Rode from Midland. Lane three, Allie Jaster from Midland Dow. Lane four, Tehus Srinivas. In lane five, Lauren Ranalski from Midland Dow. And in lane six, from Midland, Julia Powers. Heat two of 100-yard freestyle. And some of the accomplishments from, we'll cover from the Dow High team this year. The Dow High team qualified for the state relays and all three relays very early this year, and have already had one swimmer, Chelsea Fenton, qualify in the 500 free, and she was able to drop 29 seconds from her personal best coming into the season. So big improvement along the year to qualify for state at the recent MISCA meet. They've got a couple other girls who are very close to qualifying in events, even though the times got faster this year. So that was the one thing about the state meet, that qualifying times were lower this year. Currently, Dow High has a team of eight athletes going to the state meet. Those are Maggie Dooley, Elizabeth Maraskin, Hannah Jacobs, Chelsea Fenton, Sarah Saeed, Kelly Ballard, and Jenna Lee. We're going to have the start of the 100 freestyle. And they're off. This is the heat three. Other qualifiers. The one thing about this year's team, with the large number of graduates last year, is that there's only been one repeat qualifier from the team last year, and that was Hannah Jacobs, who qualified in 100 backstroke. Jenna Lee and Kelly Ballard are seniors this year, and while they went last year as backups, this year they'll be going as actual swimmers in the relay events this year. And Elizabeth Maraskin will also be competing this year for the first time. She went as an alternate a few years ago, but this will be the first time all of these seniors, especially, will be competing in a state meet. So really nice accomplishments throughout the year from them.
So as we watch this heat of the 100 free, we have Dow leading in lanes three and five.
with the balance of the field. Midland and Dow actually close behind. Solid finish coming here.
Yep, this is heat number two. So the winner of this heat was Allie Jaster from Midland Dow. Her time was 1:11.68. Again, a personal best by a second. So continue to see a lot of dropping in the exhibition heats. Our swimmers improving their time. Congratulations, Allie. Next heat is heat three of the 100-yard freestyle. Lane one, Jackie Lee from Midland Dow. Lane two, Danya McDonald from Midland. Lane three, Emily Schulteis from Midland Dow. Lane four, Gabby Holman, Midland. Lane five, Brock Schultz, Midland Dow. And lane six from Midland, Rachel Crowley. Heat 304, 100 freestyle.
I'd like to take this moment to, as we've been watching the meet, the swimmers are launching off the blocks. The blocks are actually new this year. The Booster Club, which raises money for athletics both at Midland High and Dow High, were, after several years of planning and also fundraising, were successful in acquiring the blocks that you're observing at the end of the pool there. So I think the other set of blocks were largely original to the pool. And this is a significant upgrade. So, we got a close-up. This is a significant upgrade. It's a large platform that can actually step up to the top from the side very safe. I can comment, having put my timing pads in today, that the surface is very rough. So it's a very safe surface for the swimmers to be standing on and also for them to launch and start their races from.
So. Very nice swim from Emily Schulteis, taking first place in that heat. Time of 58.23, and actually just beat her best time. So congratulations to Emily in this heat. Very fast time. But the other thing I heard about the blocks, Kurt, is they're actually a little higher, because the other ones that we had, the older ones, were slightly lower than regulation, which is fair, but it makes the swimmers go slower. So that additional height actually can help improve the swimmer's time and still be in regulation of the pool dimensions. So. So it was a needed upgrade, and again, the boosters were significant in doing that. So now we're in the finals of the 100-yard freestyle. Lane one, Elizabeth Maraskin from Dow. Lane two, Courtney Kaiser from Midland. Lane three, Sarah Saeed from Midland Dow. Lane three. Lane four, Emily Crush, Midland. Lane five, Jenna Lee, Midland Dow. And lane six, Katie Burkett, Midland. So this will be a pretty fast heat. A lot of times under 1 minute. Here, and strong start by Jenna Lee in lane five. Lane four, Emily Crush battling out between the two Midland swimmers. Coming to the last turn, very close race continuing. It's going to be a tight one. Right now, head to head, Jenna Lee and Sarah Saeed. And Emily Crush, very close race. Probably the closest race all night. Big swims.
Wow.
All swimmers within 1 second on this one, Kurt. First to third place. Here's the finish. First place was lane three, Sarah Saeed. In second place, lane five was Jenna Lee. And in third place was Emily Crush from Midland. Personal best for Emily Crush for the 58 seconds. So we're going to move to the next event is the 500-yard freestyle. That's 20 lengths of the pool, and that's for high school swimming is considered the distance race of the evening. And there'll be one heat of this event. And in lane one will be Veronica Matthews from Dow. Lane two, Anna Schulteis from Midland. Lane three, Megan Pasarczyk from Midland. She's a senior. Catherine Veneer, the senior from Midland. In lane four, Katie White, freshman from Midland Dow. And Maddie Allen from Midland. In lane six. This is more of a strategy event. Some people take it out slow and bring it back hard. Others go out hard and hold on. A lot of strategy and how you pace yourself.
To build on Doug's comment about the pacing strategy, the Booster Club also raised money to purchase these pacing devices that the swimmers can place on the inside of their cap while they train. And the coaches have a specific code that they type in so that it'll beep at a certain rate. So as the swimmers practice while they train, they can get a sense of the rate that they should be swimming and help them pace so that they can train to perform in the meet as we see tonight.
So you see a fresh start. Lanes 3, 4, and 5 are pretty much dead even and coming into the first 100. It's like in first place is so far is lane 5, Katie White, followed by Megan Pasarczyk in lane 3, and in lane 4, Kelly Bernier. So it'll be interesting to see how the places change as we go through. I'm sorry, Catherine Bernier, not Kelly Bernier. Excuse me.
So we have how many seniors in the event?
So we have Catherine Bernier, a senior from Midland, and Megan Pasarczyk is a senior from Dow High. And I know Megan had mentioned in her announcement during the honors thing that this was her favorite event. She must be a glutton for punishment. So.
A significant amount of character by this point.
Yes, yes. You don't do this event lightly.
Speaking from the parents' point of view, it is a privilege to actually watch a son or daughter actually swim this event. You really have a chance to take in the event and watch them swim over 20 lengths. As my father commented in the past, it's a unique sport in that you go to the swimming meet hoping to see your child swim less, which seems a bit counterintuitive. But the 20 lengths of the pool and the 500 free gives you plenty of time to take that in, and hopefully you'll see them swim less in that time as well.
And we're coming up on the halfway point. Currently still leading the pack in lane 5 is Katie White, and followed closely in a duel, right now a dogfight for second between Megan Pasarczyk and Catherine Bernier. So good race, Kurt.
Wow. I've noticed over the years the coaches develop a secret code to communicate with the swimmers through the counters. If they sway the numbers back and forth, or up and down, or hold steady.
This is one event where you're allowed a counter to help you count the laps, because you can miscount while you're swimming. And then you'll see the lead swimmer will get the buzzer sound indicating that there's two lengths left. That you'll see counters at the end of the pool. We might not be able to get a shot of them today, but you'll see them counting for the swimmers, and then when they get down to the last lap, they usually will indicate through an orange placard that it's the last lap. So they are warned. So we're coming up I think there's 150 to go.
As Doug mentioned, sometimes you, with all the safeguards, you can miscount. And we did have a swimmer earlier this year swim a bonus 2 lengths, 22 in the 20-length race, so exceeding expectations.
A little extra practice, but it can happen. It's a really demanding race, but I see that swimmers here usually are the ones with very good technique, very long stroke. Yeah, and you can see a nice shot of the counters down at the end of the pool. And we'll see now, I believe we're to the, just 100 yards left. Katie White still leading, freshman from Midland Dow. So her father announced for the meet, very happy.
Looking strong, really strong, looking long, smooth.
This is about the point where kids get tired though, so stay out of their way. But looks like they're finishing up strong here. You'll see the different techniques. A lot of breathing. Breathing is very important in this race to hold your stroke and keep your pace going throughout the race.
And you probably just saw that on the television.
You'll see they're ringing the bell now for the lead swimmer. Katie White, as she does her last loop turn, that means 2 lengths to the pool left. So now you'll see a lot of sprinting for those who haven't left. So we'll see. Could still be a close finish.
Oh, that's tight.
Real battle for second place between Megan Bisarczyk and Catherine Veneer. It's going to come down prior to the last lap. And here they come.
Wow.
Here they come. It's going to be tight for second. Very close race. Here she comes.
Wow.
Whoa! Oh. Very close after all that distance, finding yeah. Second place. So it looks like Katie White with a time of 5:55.82 took first, second place. Right now it looks like lane four, Catherine Veneer just touching out Megan Pisarczyk with a second. And then we're going to see a close-up of the finish here. Let's see how close that was. Here's what 1/10 of a second looks like at the finish. Here we come for second place. Look at the close at the finish. Stretch for the wall. Nice finish. Very close. Good race.
Oh, and a very well-deserved 1 length to relax.
So they'll get 1 length as they set up for the next event, which is a relay event. This will be the girls' 200 free relay. So this is the sprint relay. Each swimmer will swim two lengths of the pool before the next swimmer jumps in. And there'll be 2 heats of this event. In the first heat, from Midland Dow, Leanne Ho, Brittany Bauer, Annika Thorsten, Carson Sass. Lane two from Midland, Hayden Rice, Maggie Dietz, Whitney Duker, and Serena Fleming Dittenbaugh. In lane three from Midland Dow, Isabel Kemp, Jackie Lee, Holly Young, Tiffany Mastorza. In lane four from Midland, Finya Achilles, Teus Serenovas, Caroline Jasmine, Julia Powers. Lane five from Midland Dow, Maddie Dittenhall, Olivia Montgomery, Brooke Schultz, and Allie Jester. And in lane six from Midland Dow, Brittany Emmerman, Amy Berry, Caitlin Carr, and Emily Dean. Now here they'll watch, one of the things you want to watch is the exchanges, because you can really benefit if you get a good start, because the rule is you can be over the water, but your feet can't leave the block until the other person touches. So if you time it just right, you can get a significant benefit from a good turn. So you will see it here on the exchanges. You see that a good swimmer can be right over the top of the water just as the other one's touching. So you can, in theory, you can get a much faster split of a 50 freestyle time off a relay start. Sometimes you can improve your best time by almost a full second.
Seamless transition.
Yeah, if you got it perfect, you can really do some well. At the same time, if you're slow off the block, it can hurt your team or be slower. But it's better to be safe than sorry sometimes, because of course if you leave early, your team will be disqualified. So there's no baton in swimming, but you still can get disqualified for a bad exchange.
and I don't know if it's a training meet or not, but or it's at the national level or the Olympic level, but they have sensors in some of the surfaces of the blocks where they can actually track the delta between the touch and the toes leaving.
Wow.
And as you might imagine, like, that differential actually narrows down to the Olympic level, which is like hundredths of a second.
Yeah.
Where at the high school level, it's probably tenths or more.
Yeah. And as mentioned, both of the goals for the team, Midland and Dow High, is to do well in the upcoming Valley meet. And you'll see both will be training to taper and peak at that event. But it's also at Saginaw Valley State University, very nice facility and a lot of technology. The other parts of the technology that you'll see that's very effective for the girl swimmers is that they'll actually even have these technical swimsuits now. And these are also called fast suits. And these can greatly improve their time in some of these events. So on top of being trained and tapered, and then they'll put on special suits that will last sometimes just for that weekend. But it really helps both mentally and physically for them to be at their peak. And generally you see tremendous drops in that meet. And the Saginaw Valley pool is also known to be a very fast pool. So the first heat of this event, first place, was lane three. That was the team from Midland Dow by Isabel Kempel, Jackie Lee, Holly Young, and Tiffany Storzak. Good job, girls. And again, they'll take the one lap warm down before the next event. As the second heat gets up, this will be the final. In lane one, it'll be Sarah Brandstedt, Chelsea Fenton, Lauren McLean, and Megan Pisarjic. In lane two, from Midland, Rachel Schneider, Natalie Halpin, Stephanie Lynch, and Brittany Duford. In lane three, from Midland Dow, Hannah Jacobs, Elizabeth Maraskin, Sarah Sayed, and Jenna Lee. In lane four, from Midland, Allie Kay Kiefer, Emily Crush, Courtney Kaiser, and Catherine Vernier. In lane five will be Maggie Dooley, Kaylee Niederstadt, Emily Schulteis, and Morgan Herschel. And in lane six will be Taylor Fagan, Bryn Rode, Holly Stauffer, and Danya McDonald. This should be a close race between lanes three and four. And this is the sprinter's race, so your fastest sprinters will be in this race, one on top of each other. Right now, it looks like Dow's move out to the early lead. Nice swim by Hannah Jacobs, getting the team out ahead. The strategy in the relays, sometimes people will change it differently. It used to be that, historically, that you put your fastest swimmer last, but it's not the case anymore. Depending on the matchups in the relay, many times your fastest swimmer, the one with the strongest off-the-block start, will go first in order to get the team out to the early lead and also put pressure on maybe some of the slower swimmers to stay and keep the lead, to optimize and get the best time. So coaches and swimmers have different strategies to this event, but you never know sometimes what you're going to get until that last swimmer swim.
Well, and as Doug mentioned, the transitions, the starts, playing that game so that you can actually optimize the time. Wow, lane three is really moving.
Here's some of the exchanges coming up. Here they come. Looks like a very nice time by Midland Dow. Finishing up.
Nice
time, 1:45. That's pretty close to a best time. No, a little bit off, but still solid swim for this time of the season.
Nice swim.
Second place was the second Midland Dow team, and third place with Midland with a time of 1:53.40, the team from Midland Dow. That was Allie Keekaper, Emily Crush, Courtney Kaiser, and Catherine Vernier.
Well, and as Doug mentioned with the upcoming league meet, the relays are quite significant. They're worth twice the number of points as the individuals, both here in the dual meet tonight as well as actually at the upcoming championship meet. So the attention, the ability to perform, score high
can be highly beneficial to a team.
Yeah, and talking with the coach, Renee Allen from Midland Dow, this is going to be a very different year. Their strategy for competing in these meets is quite different. With all the seniors graduating last year, Midland Dow is really focusing on their depth and trying to get massive improvement from all their swimmers. Saginaw Heritage has a very, very strong team this year. And in the Tri-City meet, Saginaw Heritage took more first places than Dow did. But because of the depth, Dow was able to outpoint Saginaw Heritage barely in the Tri-City meet. In the Valleys, it's going to be just as tight. Slightly different slate of teams, but it'll be very competitive. So their focus this year is to swim as a team and to see improvement across the board. So I think it's going to be a challenge for them to get their 10th consecutive championship. But this will be the tightest challenge they've had in probably 10 years. So it'll be worth coming out to the meet in 3 weeks. I believe it's the weekend of November 4th.
That's right.
And hopefully there'll be a good turnout for a very close invitational meet this year. We're into the 100 backstroke now. Heat 1, lane 1, Amy Berry from Midland Dow. Lane 2 from Midland, Taylor Fagan. Lane 3, Holly Young from Midland Dow. Lane 4 from Midland, Melissa Henning. Lane 5, Veronica Matthews from Dow. And lane 6, Brittany Duford.
This stroke is really quite demanding, especially from the standpoint of just driving your legs as they make their way through four lengths of backstroke. You have to just continually kick and propel your body forward while kind of almost like surfing. As you can see, this event requires the use of the flags. The flags help the swimmers know like when the wall is approaching so they can prepare to do their turns and finish strong.
Yeah, and we'll catch it, I'm sure, in the next heat as well. If you focus on the turns after the first 50, those flags are really important as they adjust their timing because they have just basically one stroke to turn over and do a flip turn. You take an additional stroke, you're disqualified. So understanding the timing and counting the strokes into the wall becomes a critical element to a fast race. You'll see in the first heat, first place was lane 3. That was Holly Young from Midland Dow with a time of 111.64. And in second place, lane 5 from Midland Dow was Veronica Matthews, a freshman from Dow. Good swim, Veronica, and her time was 116.13. And in third place, in lane 1, also from Dow, was Amy Berry. So now we're in the second heat of the 100 back. This will be the finals. In lane 1, Anne-Marie Molinar, senior from Dow. Lane 2, Allie Akikafer, senior from Midland High. Lane 3, Hannah Jacobs, junior from Dow. Emily Crush, junior from Midland. Lane 5, Anna Alsup, senior from Dow. And Katie Burkhart, to go along with all the upperclassmen and freshmen from Midland High.
So, Doug, are there rules of how far they can kick underwater before they come up and swim?
Yeah, so if you notice on the lane lines, you'll see that red marker. So it's all yellow and white, but where you see that red marker, that's the point at which they have to be stroking coming from the far side. So it's quite a distance. It's almost two-thirds of the length of the pool, but that's what that red indicator is for. So you'll see close-ups of the turn here. Notice the time and the flip. And a good turn, very smooth. All these finalists do it very well. In lane 3, Hannah Jacobs. This is the event she qualified for the state meet last year. So this is her specialty. And really showing it here with a very solid swim. Second place for Midland, Emily Crush. Closing at the end. It looks like first, Hannah Jacobs, and second from Midland. Emily Crush, very nice swim.
So you might be wondering, like, how do they swim so straight when they're on their back? You might notice that we have a grid in the ceiling, but I happen to know, being on the pool deck looking up, they actually have green lines.
So the swimmer, they can actually focus on that line or on the grid, and they can help them orient. But I imagine after thousands of miles swim in practice, they swim naturally straight anyway.
So the next event will be the 100-yard breaststroke. And there'll be two heats of this event. And lane one will be Maddie Dauenhauer from Midland Dow. Lane two, Caroline Jassen from Midland. Lane three, Brittany Bauer from Midland Dow. Holly Stouffer, lane four from Midland. And lane five, Tiffany Nestorczyk from Nestorczyk from Midland Dow.
Two heats.
There will be two heats of this event. This is the exhibition heat. Of course, breaststroke is one of those events that's kind of seen as a specialty event because obviously the stroke is quite different than all the other events. It's an underwater pole, and of course, an infamous breaststroke or frog kick. Breaststrokers generally are a unique breed in the sense that people that excel at breaststroke are usually very specialized in that event, and they also make good IMers, again, because it's one of the more technically challenging events, and for many, yep, and here and you can see up leading the charge on the breaststroke, and again, a two-hand touch, she'll be coming up to the turn here. You see they push off and they get the long underwater stroke. But breaststroke is, again, usually breaststrokers are very strong, of course, in this stroke, but also make good IMers, as I said, Kurt. And the training regimen is quite different, and the muscle groups, as you can imagine, are quite different. So an accomplished breaststroker is a rare thing, and you need to have these specialists on your team in any meet. It's also the Achilles heels of many of the sprinters and butterflies. In swimming, there's a sport, an event for everybody.
Indeed. I was just reflecting that this summer at the 2015 Pan American Games that were hosted in Toronto, Brad Craig, who is the record holder who graduated from Dow High, actually swam in the 200 meter breaststroke. And so he was featured live on ESPN swimming this event, but four additional lengths.
Excellent, yeah. We have a long history of some very strong breaststrokers coming out of this area. So in the first heat, lane three, Brittany Howard won the first heat with a time of 1:23.06. And again, the best time for her, so congratulations, Brittany. Well done. Heat two in lane one, Kaylee Niederstadt, Midland Dow. Lane two, Serena Fleming Dittenberg. In lane three, Kelly Ballard from Dow. In lane four, Natalie Halpin from Midland. In lane five, Abby Cook from Dow. And in lane six, Julia Quinn. So this will be the last heat of the individual events, and we'll go to the final relay.
Actually, as I mentioned about Brad Craig, was it Jessie Cojedo?
Yeah, Jessie Cojedo also swam for Midland High, and she was also an outstanding Olympic trial swimmer.
Exactly.
From the Midland area. She went to the University of Louisville.
Was she a breaststroker as well?
She was a very strong breaststroker. That was her specialty event, yes. So two of the probably the most renowned swimmers out of this area are breaststroking.
And as I mentioned that both of them actually coming from club swimming into the high school program and then on to their university and national programs.
Yeah, that's as we get towards the end of the meet, that's the one thing that the coaches wanted to mention is, like, if you look at the history of coaching, all of these coaches have been coaching probably since the 80s. And at one time or another, they've all coached with each other, coached against each other in age group swimming, high school swimming, junior high swimming. So there's a long tradition of very experienced coaches in the area, and it's probably what makes Midland, the Midland High region, such a strong swimming region in the area. The swimmers here travel many times to Grand Rapids and the Detroit area and do very well for the small size of the community that Midland is. We are overrepresented in the quality of swimming.
That truly is unique because, go ahead.
And we're into the last relay, so this is the second heat of the breaststroke taking off. And then, like I said, this should be a pretty close race between Bradley 3 and Meg 5. Very close swimmers from Dow High all around the same time in this event. And Natalie Helpin from Midland also should be a very close race.
I was just going to comment that Coach Hall had mentioned to us that she had previously, as Doug mentioned, been coached by Coach Renee.
Okay.
She had previously been coached by Coach Chile for one summer, but yet they coached together and coached each other's kids, and truly very supportive of one another.
Yeah, in the swimming community, you're either a parent, a coach, or both, you know.
Close race here.
I mean, sometimes you're coached when you're not a parent. It's hard to do both. So some parents actually stop coaching while their kids are swimming and then leave it up to the experienced coaches in the area, and then they re-engage in swimming later on. Coming into the final finish here, very close.
Wow,
very close. Very nice swim. Big surprise from Abby Cook on the outside with a very nice swim. First place, 118.22. Second place was lane 3. With a 119.46 and a very close finish with Natalie Halpin, who took third place for Midland High. Before I get a close-up, there it is. Nice shot of the finish, underwater finish. Now we're into the last event of the evening. This will be the 400-yard freestyle relay. There will only be one heat, a finals heat. And in lane 1 will be Sarah Brandstadt, Hannah Jacobs, Abby Cook, and Katie White. In lane 1 from Dow, in lane 2 from Midland, Maddie Allen, Melissa Henning, Julia Quinn, Rachel Schneider. In lane 3 from MDOW is Elizabeth Moraskin, Kelly Ballard, Anna Alsup, and Megan Pisarczyk. In lane 4, Courtney Kaiser, Delaney Randall, Katie Burchett, and Anna Schulteis. In lane 5 from Dow, Lauren McLean, Chelsea Fenton, Morgan Herschel, and Sarah Saeed. In lane 6 from Midland, Rachel Crowley, Olivia Barber, Judy Powers, and Maggie Deeks. Final event of the evening, 400 freestyle relay. And upon the conclusion event, we'll try to announce the scores before we check out. There might be a lot of activity after the event and celebration. And again, very close race. Slight lead in lane 1, but pretty tight bundling for the first swim. Like lane 3, Elizabeth Moraskin with the early lead for Dow. But right now, between lanes 1 and 5 for Dow and lane 4 for Midland, fight for second place. Into the first exchange, here we go. In the water from Dow is Kelly Ballard. And in lane 1 from Dow, entering the water will be Hannah Jacobs. And in lane 5 for Dow Swimming, now is Chelsea Fenton.
Neck and neck there.
Yep, looks like they're closing a little bit, so everything's tightening up here in the second lap.
Gracious.
Yep, it's starting to close up, especially the fight for second. Looks like lane 1 is moving up, the challenge for the lead. Closing pretty quickly on the turn. And now we have lane 1 in first place. The team from Dow, Hannah Jacobs swimming. Nice leg of the ball. Going to be very close as we get into the third leg. Team's lane 1 and 3 right now.
So, Doug, who is swimming the third leg here?
The third leg in lane 1 is Abby Cook, junior from Midland Dow. And lane 3 for Midland Dow is Anna Alsa. See, lane three has now taken a slight lead, and now lane five now has moved into second place. They're moving back and forth, so they mixed up the swimmers pretty well in this event. This is where depth can really help you. You can mix your relays up for the strategy for the Saginaw Valley meet, maybe divide the relays to get higher places for both relays. And there's a lot of swimmers, and I know in the Dow squad, that are very similar times in 103, so the swimmers really compete for those slots. And the final swimmers entering the water here. Right now it looks like a race between lane three and lane five. And then for third, between one and lane four. Very close finish. It's like lane five just touches out lane three. And then third place, big fight for the finish here. It's like lane one. So Dow took a 1-2 and a third place in that event. Fourth place Midland. And here we go, the final heat and final lap finish. Slow motion. Here they come. Really close race with lane five just touching out lane three. And so that was the team of Lauren McLean, Chelsea Fenton, Morgan Herschel, and Sarah Saeed. So we should come back with results here very shortly, and we'll do our little wrap-up. But while we wait, we can make final announcements.
So you are watching this Midland High versus Dow High swim meet on MPS-TV 190 on Charter, or Channel 99 on AT&T U-verse in Midland. This event will be shown at the following dates and times: Wednesday, October 21st at 12:45 p.m. Thursday, October 22nd at 1:15 p.m. Friday, October 23rd at 1:15 p.m. Saturday, October 24th at 1 p.m. For more dates and times or to stream this program online, check the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org. The coverage of the swim meet is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one...
Hold on, Kurt. I think they're going to do... Nope. I thought they were going to do the final results. Go ahead, Kurt. Sorry.
Oh, no worries. Come to the next orientation studio training class on Saturday, November 14th from 10 to 1 to start your training. Learn about MCTV and how to become a TV producer and get hands-on training to become a volunteer. The cost is just $45, which includes your first-year access membership fee. Call 837-3474. Come down to MCTV studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. Learn more at www.cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV or follow us on Facebook.
And Kurt, it was a pleasure. We had a lot of fun doing this, so I think if we can do it, anyone can do it. So I encourage others who are aspiring announcers and sportscasters to come out and give it a shot. It's all good for the community. And it was a pleasure. I always have fun with you, Kurt. And hopefully we'll get a chance to do this again. So as we listen up for the final scores, then be able to close out the meet. But a fantastic night here for all the swimmers, and I think as we're waiting for the announcement of the final scores.
And you're getting a glimpse of some of the crowd that's remaining here at the very end. Parents, grandparents, younger brothers and sisters, future swimmers.
And the swimmers, after the announcement, they'll probably get back in and do a longer warm down. You know, because they'll be back in the pool. The one thing about swimming in the high school, especially in this area, it does take, again, just a huge amount of dedication. Not only do these swimmers sometimes swim over 2 hours a day and weight train for 45 minutes, but many times, three times a week, they're swimming 2 hours even before school. So I know the girls get up sometimes as early as 4:15 in the morning to make these morning practices. So by this time of the year, they're very tired, and there's no question that physically demanding sport, both mentally, and speaking for a parent that has to drive them at 4:30 in the morning, for the parents as well. So all the effort, as you can see tonight, was worth it, right, Kurt?
Absolutely. And during the senior night, we heard a couple seniors actually shout out to the breakfasts that were prepared for the morning practices, prepared by the parents, all the parents, to provide them with nutrition before they start their academic day.
Yeah, so I mean, it's an effort, you know, the parents and the volunteers. We can't do these things without all that effort. And I know some of those breakfasts are fantastic, so it makes you want to come and swim, almost.
On civil time of day. Although they are working right now to put together, I think, a recipe book.
Yeah, I mean, I noticed the parents got together this year and they share the recipes across, and you know, it helps out the other parents. And the other thing, huge effort by the team, what they call the team moms for the girls team, to coordinate all the activities for driving, for breakfast, for meals, for away meets. It really doesn't happen with you know, just tons of effort. You'll see here now the teams are congratulating each other, you know, walking the length of deck before they do their final warm down. And I'm assuming this might be the wrap-up, Kurt. From my calculations, it does look like that Dow High did win the dual meet tonight. And I don't have the exact score, but I think we can safely say that today's winner was Midland Dow. But I think, as you saw from all the cooperation, that everyone really turned out, and a lot of good swims tonight. So any final comments, Kurt?
Just two deep teams having fun competing. A lot of support from the community. So thank you to those out there that are helping. Yeah, just great fun. I think this is actually the first event during the Midland Dow week. We've been told that it starts with the swim meet tonight. I think then as the week goes on, there's a volleyball match. Of course, there's the football match on Friday. But soccer teams do well in their districts. They'll be playing each other on Wednesday. So, you know, four sports, Midland Dow, all week long.
Can't say more than that. So with that, why don't we call it a night, Kurt? And thanks for the audience for joining. And again, look at the website for the retelecast if you want to see portions or all of the event in its completion. So good night, everyone, and have a good evening.
Take care.